In this video, I'm going to show you how to take a blank wall, create a street art animation, and place it over the top. First, I'm going to show you how to make this animation here using some really useful techniques, and then we're going to composite it on top of our photo. I did this in collaboration with the amazing photographer Demas Rusli, and he shares some awesome tips and breakdowns of his just crazy photo edits on his YouTube channel. And he also hosts the awesome podcast 5-9 as well, that I highly recommend if you want to hear about the different journeys of fellow creatives and how they've managed to get a foothold in their industry. Now in a new comp, I'm going to start on that bursting angular shape by creating a new solid with Control plus Y. And we don't need to worry about the color, and let's just rename it Starburst, because we always label our layers. And then let's go and add the effect Radio Waves. Now this is a really awesome effect to quickly get a shape radiating out from the center. But we don't want a circle, we want our own spiky star shape. So with our pen tool selected, let's draw a mask over this layer, creating a starburst shape. And then we want to change the wave type over here to mask, and then the mask to mask one. And now we can see we've got our mask radiating this shape. Let's just move this mask up slightly so it's more near the center, and the burst is coming from the middle. There we are. And now let's go over after our producer point and then drag the y-axis down so it is coming from the bottom. And we don't really need to see the bottom half at all. And because we want this scene to start with our star already filling the wall, we're just going to click and drag this over to the left and then extend it a little bit and just keep dragging it over. So as soon as this comp starts, we've already got a lot of shapes here, and you can see it's starting to fade out at the end here as well. So let's change the fade out time from 5 down to 0 and change the lifespan up to something really large so that they don't ever fade out. Now we've got our radiating shape. We can adjust the frequency settings to change the space in between them. I want mine a little more spread out. Something around here is fine. And then let's change the stroke color to black. Done. Now for those swirly circle shapes. Let's select our ellipse tool up here. Make sure its stroke is set to black and 5 pixels, which is the same as our radiating mask here. And let's hold shift and just draw a circle in the middle of our comp. And now we're going to keyframe its position by pressing P on our keyboard, clicking the stopwatch, and a little while in, move it down to the left, then up, and then back down to the right. And we want to create a nice sort of figure eight shape. So I'm going to select my pen tool, convert vertex tool, and then just sort of round these out. So it makes an 8. And we're just going to copy that keyframe from the start, paste that at the end. And now I've got our circle moving in an 8. Now to get this to loop, we're going to hold Alt or Option on our keyboard and click on the stopwatch to open up our expression window. And we're going to add the expression loop out, and then cycle in the brackets. And that way it will continue to cycle through these keyframes until the composition ends. Let's add some easing to those keyframes by selecting them and pressing F9. Let's see how that looks. All right, it's a little bit staggered. So what we're gonna do is go into the graph editor. This is our value graph. So I'm gonna select all of these keyframes, and then I'm just gonna drag them up from the baseline so that their speed is never 0. So they will never sort of stop moving. And let's increase the easing a little bit on these as well. As long as there's some interesting variance between how fast and slow it is, we're going to get a good effect. Now let's go and add the effect echo. Now what this does is create a delayed copy of this layer. Let's increase the number of echoes to 10, and we can see more accurately what that looks like. And this is a really handy effect for creating motion trails or smears in your animation. So let's change the echo operator to composite in front. And now we have the effect we want. To get the front circle to be a different color, we just duplicate this layer, remove the echo effect from that layer, and just go and select the fill and change it to whatever color you want. And now we have our worm shape. Now to get another version of this worm, I'm going to select both these layers, duplicate them with Control plus D, and then I'm just going to get those layers and drag them until they are pretty offset with that first worm, and then when we play it, they won't really meet. There we are. And then let's change the fill colors on both of those layers as well, so they are inverted. I'm going to select those top two layers, our new worm, and pre-comp them by pressing Control Shift C and call that Wormy01, and pre-comp our other worm as well. And then from there, I'm just going to select both of those comps, duplicate them, and then drag them and move them around our canvas, maybe offsetting their time slightly and rotating them. And let's duplicate them all again, drag them over, rotate, and then add some more offset. And now we've got our comp filled up with worm shapes, and we can go back and change the position of these later if we need to. Now let's also create a new adjustment layer to put a few effects on, and let's add the effect posterized time and set that to 12. because a lower frame rate like this is going to look a little more natural on the wall, so the animation doesn't look so super smooth and digital. 12 frames a second should work fine for this. You could go a bit lower or a bit higher. We're also going to add a turbulent displace effect. I'm going to set the amount a bit lower to 30, and then the size really low to 2 pixels. Now what this is going to do, if we zoom really close in and flick it on and off, is just create a bit of grit and bumps to these lines. So it kind of looks like the texture of the wall will have affected how these lines were painted on. And now we're ready to composite this onto our wall. So in a new comp, we have both our wall image and our street art comp ready to go. So first, let's select our art layer here and change the blending mode to multiply, which keeps only the dark value so we can see all the texture and everything underneath, and then move it around to line up the base of our star with this chap's legs. Now, our wall is facing our camera pretty much straight on, but if your wall has a bit of perspective, like this wall for example, all we need to do is add the effect power pin and then drag your corners to line it up with the edges of the wall. And there you go. And now let's remove our street art from these windows and holes in this wall and the floor as well. And to do that, we're going to use a mat. So let's create a new solid with Control plus Y, and let's make it reasonably bright so we can see it, and turn down its opacity so we can see our wall through it. And let's hide our art layer as well, because that's only going to distract us at this point. Using our pen tool up here on the left, I'm going to click and just draw a rectangle over the ground. And then I'm going to press M on our keyboard to bring up our masks and set that to subtract, and then try to line it up a little nicer as well. And we just want to mask out all the areas that aren't our wall. So I'm going to go in and draw another mask over these holes in the wall and just set them all to subtract, and continue to do that for all of them. And now we have a pink layer that covers our entire wall. So let's turn its opacity back up to 100 and make our art layer visible again. And making sure our art layer is underneath our mat, we're going to change the track mat to alpha mat. And that will only make what's visible in our mat visible on our street art layer. Now that's getting close, but our art is still going on top of this guy here. So what we could do is subtract him from our mat as well, but he is a much more complicated shape than these holes and the ground, so it's going to take a lot of time to draw perfectly around him. But because he's on a solid white background, this is going to be really easy. So all we have to do is get our wall layer over here, duplicate it, bring it on top, and with that pen tool selected, just draw roughly around him, only really making sure we don't get shadow involved. And we're going to treat this kind of like a green screen. So you could do this a couple of ways. You could add the effect color key and then select the white here, and then play with these settings until his edge looks nice. Or what we can do is add the extract effect, and this brings up this histogram where we can see the dark and light values. And because we know we just want to remove all the light values from this, we can click on this bar underneath and just drag that to the right to remove all the light values. And there we are. Now there's a couple more things to make this effect look a lot more realistic. The first thing to do is sort of color match our art with the scene. Now we've got a pretty limited color palette and it's mostly neutral, so the only thing I think we need to do here is turn the opacity down to maybe 85. So that will just give a little bit more texture that's visible underneath our layer and make these bright colors a bit more muted. And let's add some more texture to our art as well. So I'm going to open up our art layer and I'm going to drag in this paper texture that I have here. I'm going to add a curves effect and really increase the contrast. And we want to see a lot of black and then a few speckles of white here as well. And then what I'm going to do is change the blending mode of this to silhouette luma. Now when we do that, it doesn't look like there's much happening, except we can see a couple of specks of our white showing through here. But what this is actually doing is these white spots here, all the white from our paper layer, are cutting through all the layers underneath and making them transparent. If we turn our transparency grid on, go into our composition settings and change the background color to pink, which isn't actually visible. And now you can see that these white areas are cutting through and making it 100% transparent. And we can add more of that as well by changing the contrast on this curves effect of our texture here. There, that's a little more like it. Now if we go back into our street scene, we can see that that paper texture kind of looks like the paint has been worn away on these areas here, which makes it look a little more realistic, the compositing. And to finish it off, I added these yellow dripping shapes to kind of make a little more use of these really interesting windows in this building here. Now this drip was done on a single shape layer with three shapes inside it. We have a little ellipse that just falls down and then gets removed, and a little sort of splash shape, and then a bit of path animation on this top shape here where the drip stretches down. And I added some smiley faces for fun as well. And you can take a closer look at those in the project files, which you can download for free down in the description.
I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.